Girls, welcome back to the Solid Rock Children's Church. Today we have loads and loads of lovely activities for you guys, and I hope you know you are ready to enjoy every one of them. So we're going to start with our worship. We have the memory verse. Remember, we have our story time, and after our story time we're going to have our lesson. And you know, this in the lesson, that's where we discuss, you know, everything that we learn from our story, okay? And remember, we always have a quiz and our homework. So make sure, boys and girls, to participate in all of it, okay? And you know what? I'm going to see you at the lesson. God bless you.
How are you all? I have missed you so much, and it's good to be with you again. Okay, we are going to be doing a song this morning called "I Am a Friend of God." Ask your brother, your sister, are you a friend of God? Yes, I am a friend of God. Are you ready? Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Hey, one, two, hey, he comes me friend. Let's sing. Who am I saying? Who am I that you are thinking of me? That you hear me when I come? Yeah. Is it true that you are thinking of me? Hey. That you love me? Shout, it's amazing. Amazing. I am a friend of God. I am a friend of God. Oh, I am a friend of God. Oh, I am a friend of God. He calls me friend. I am a friend of God. I am a friend of God. Oh, I am a friend of God. Oh, I am a friend of God. He calls me friend. Now say, who am I? Let's go. Who am I that you are my true love? Let me hear you. Okay, okay. When I call, say, is it true? Say, is it true that you are thinking of me? Hey, hey, that you love me. It's amazing, it's amazing. Two more times, say, it's amazing. One more time, shout it, it's amazing. I am a friend of God, friend of God. Oh, I am a friend of God. Oh, I am a friend of God. He calls me friend. I am a friend of God. I am a friend.
Have the lesson for the week. Please listen carefully.
Stories of the Bible. The parable of the wealthy man.
This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love. He healed many people from their sickness, performed many miracles like calming storms, and even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
One day, a crowd gathered around Jesus to hear him talk. The crowd was so big that people were stepping on each other.
Hey, watch it!
Jesus was talking to his disciples when someone called out from the crowd.
Hey, Jesus!
Teacher, tell my brother to divide with me the property our father left us.
Hold on there.
Jesus said, Friend, who made me a judge over you to decide such things as that? Be careful and guard against all kinds of greed. A man's life is not measured by the many things he owns.
Huh?
Then he told them a story. A rich man had a fertile farm that produced fine crops. He said to himself, What should I do? I don't have room for all my crops.
I got it.
Then he said, I know. I'll tear down my barns and build bigger ones. Then I'll have room enough to store all my wheat and other goods. And I'll sit back and say to myself, My friend, you have enough stored away for years to come. Now take it easy. Eat, drink, and be merry. But God said to him, You fool, you will die this very night.
Wait, what?
Then who will get everything you worked for? Yes, a person is a fool to store up earthly wealth, but not have a rich relationship with God.
Welcome back, boys and girls. I hope you enjoyed every program. I hope you participated in the worship. I hope you listened to the memory verse. And remember, according to our lesson last week, we have to make our heart a good soil. So making your heart a good soil will be that you check out the memory verse and you learn them again. And you recite them and you try to do what the Word of God says. Okay? So let's go back to the lesson of today. Today we are learning about the rich man, a wealthy man that was boasting with all his riches, you know, and on the parable was saying on that very night, God said, this is it, you know, you are finished now, your time on earth is finished, you're coming, you know, over to the other side. Boys and girls, you know, we can have so many prized possessions on this earth. You know, I know you guys don't have anything yet because you're kids, but you're going to grow up and you're going to work and you're going to be successful in life. So what this particular passage is telling us is that whatever it is that we are able to gather, you know, that we are able to be proud of, that we, you know, this is our handwork and we've worked for this and we've been able to achieve this, we've been able to make this. God is saying, don't be boastful of those things. Because really, those things don't really matter. You know why? Because we are on earth here to build our relationship with God. We are only going to be here on earth for a short time. I mean, short time might be 70, it might be 80 years, but it is short compared to eternity. You know, eternity is when we die, eventually, when we, you know, grow old and we die, we are going to heaven, or God forbid we go to hell. And the only way we can actually avoid, you know, going to hell is to build a relationship with God, to actually, you know, make sure that we are children of God. And I know you are, so don't be worrying, okay? We just have to make sure that we don't place values on the things that we own here on earth. Because we're not going to take them anywhere, boys and girls. God bless you, and make sure that you tell your friends who don't believe in God. Tell them about God. You know, you there are a child of God, and you should spread the good news as well in your own way. God bless you, boys and girls, and I'll see you next week.
Hello, friends. How you doing? So, you know what time it is. Yeah, it's quiz time. Yeah, so let's get straight right into it. But then before we go into it, I want you to know that all the questions today are home quizzes. So that means that you send your answers to the email provided and you stand a chance to win the prize. The first correct answer wins the prize in church. So let's get straight into it. First question, where is this found? Where is this found? Fool, this night your soul will be required of you. Luke chapter 20, verse 12, verse 20. Luke chapter 12, verse 20. A, in the parable of the sower. B, in the parable of the prodigal son. C, in the parable of the rich fool. Next question. Take heed and beware of covetousness means. Take heed and beware of covetousness means. A, be thankful. B, be aware of wanting to have other people's things. C, don't be greedy. What does that mean? Next question. One of the brothers asked Jesus to A, settle an argument between his brother. B, convince his brother to divide their inheritance. C, convince his brother to divide their food. Next question. Why did the rich man in the parable build a barn? Why did the rich man in the parable build a barn? A, to give to the poor. B, because he lost his house. C, to have a place to put all his possessions. Next question. What happened to the rich fool? What happened to the rich fool? A, he invited his friends. B, he died before he could enjoy his possessions. C, he lived happily ever after. A, he invited his friends. B, he died before he could enjoy his possessions. C, he lived happily ever after. And the last question. Jesus wanted the people in the crowd to understand that true happiness is found only in where? A, money. B, hard work. C, the kingdom of God. Sorry, that wasn't the last question. The last question is number 7. So now we go. From this parable, we learn to put God as our dash priority. A, first. B, second. C, last. So if you have answers, send them to the email address, the church email address. You know how we do it. Have a nice day. Bye.